Good afternoon. Welcome to the fabulous Fox Theater. Believe it or not, this is Jack Moelmann. And I'm speaking to you from the mighty Wurlitzer organ console, which at the present time is in the basement of this beautiful theater. Looking around here, it's your typical basement, dark and damp and stuff all over the place. But I only hope to be here a very short time. I want to at least get out of here before the water rises. Anyway, we have to do the usual pre-show announcements before we can begin. Please turn off your cell phones and other electronic devices and just hope that you didn't leave the bathtub water running in your home before you came here today. We frown upon any kind of recording and flash photography during the show, especially when I'm playing. If you feel compelled to send text messages during the show, save them until you go to one of our specially equipped rooms we have set aside for this purpose. The rooms are identified by the words ladies and gentlemen, or to keep it simple, men and women. So much for the announcements. I will see you shortly, assuming I can get this thing to move. In the meantime, direct from New Jersey, where we can always hope that their weather is worse than ours, please welcome our master of ceremonies, Mr. Nelson Page.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the fabulous Fox Theater here in St. Louis. This is a privilege for me because of my association with Jack these many years. We have an incredibly special program for you today. It is Those Were the Days. Those were the days. Those were the days when this theater was built and when gas was 14 cents a gallon and when gold was $19 an ounce, when the average worker made $23 a week, and when life expectancy was 56 years old. But you know what? At the end of all that, this theater was born. That period brought forth this beautiful Siamese, Byzantine temple of entertainment. And you are going to witness something that very few people see now on a regular basis. This is the first time that this instrument has been showcased in many, many years. And you're a witness to a bit of that history. We have three amazing organists here today. Of course, our featured organist is two gentlemen who I know you'll really enjoy their performances. One is Lou Williams, the great Lou Williams, and of course the one and only Walt Strony, and they'll be playing, you know, right after the opening event here today. But you know, Jack Moelmann, and I was happy to hear that you applauded, Jack is a true transmitter of theater organ culture. He did something that nobody else did. 7 years ago, actually 7 years ago this month, he rented Radio City Music Hall and became an international celebrity. International celebrity. And we thought that this would be a great idea to do it one more time. And Jack, once again, dug in his pocket and made sure that all the expenses came out of his pocket and that he could take care of it so that he could make sure that this wonderful sound of this very iconic instrument can be presented to you here today. So you know what? It gives me great pleasure to introduce you. Before I do that, I'm thinking, I can't tell my introduction 7 years ago. So why don't we let the DVD speak for itself? Mr. Projectionist, please.
You know, for those of you who've never met Jack, if he'd come up to you and shake your hand, he would say, you know what, I've known you since the first day I met you. And if you ever ask his biographical information, he'll say he was born at a very early age. But we're honored to be his friend, we're honored to have him here on the great stage. And ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce the star of our show, Colonel Jack Moelmann!
Thank you.
got out of the water just in time. Welcome to the Fabulous Fox Theater, and I hope you enjoyed the program today. You might as well. You've locked the doors, you can't get out. You know, I wasn't too sure how many people we were gonna have, even though we advertised two other organists that are actually better players than I am because they told me so. But it was several years ago in Biloxi, Mississippi, when I was stationed down there, that there was this little stage play, and I was the MC. And we weren't too sure exactly how many people were gonna show up. Well, it was approaching 8 o'clock, and I looked out in the audience, and there wasn't anybody there. I thought, boy, this could happen here at the Fox, too. There wasn't anybody there. Finally, somebody came in and walked halfway down in the auditorium in the seats, sat down. 8 o'clock came, I said, good evening, sir. You're the only one in the audience. We're gonna do the whole thing for you, leave nothing out, and hope you enjoy it. The guy stood up, said, do what you're gonna do, get on with it, I'm the janitor here, I'm gonna clean up the place and go home. It was actually the next night, we didn't know that. It actually happened, I'm not making this stuff up. First song is a trolley song. Second song is something I just dearly love. Play it all the time. It was on one of the TV shows earlier in the week from Sesame Street, 1970, called Rubber Ducky. Oh, you know it. This thing is not easy here. I'm gonna put one of these in my house. To get rid of uninvited guests. Okay. I'm not going to turn around all every whole time here, so I'll talk to this half now, I'll talk to the other half later. The balcony, forget it. I'm glad you're all here. A Cole Porter song, for those of you that are anticipating a facelift, perhaps, it's called I've Got You Under My Skin. Thank you. Now we have to turn this way. Oh, I really ought to have a mirror here so I could see you. I couldn't see you with the lights anyway. Here's a medley of some of the old-time songs. We are going to have a sing-along tonight. And we are going to have a silent movie that's only 15 minutes longer than Gone with the Wind. But these are some old familiar tunes. If you want to sing along with these, don't. Oh, I don't care, if whatever turns you on. Oh, it's a nice day. I moved here in 1986 into this area, actually over by Scott Air Force Base. It's the only place I've ever lived where you have four seasons in one day. I think today was the first day I got to use the off in the heating and air conditioning. So, anyway, here's about 25 songs or so. I can't do that, I can't see it. Doesn't matter, I don't know them anyway. Oh God, who wanted the first one over? Oh, I wasn't gonna do that one. I will do it anyway. Why should I? Oh, that's a cute one. I didn't know this organ had one of those. Thank you. good friend of mine, Father Gus Franklin, Episcopal priest, he didn't make it either. And the soloist, one of the soloists from our church, he didn't make it either. So I don't know what they did. We decided we were going to put a little religious music into the program today. We have the soloist from St. Michael's Episcopal Church who's going to join me on the stage. His name is Mr. Wynn Pardee. Would you welcome him? Well, you took the stairs. They do have an elevator. I've got to set this up, though. We are going to do one of the most beautiful songs I know, anyway. It's called The Lord's Prayer. This is the serious part of the program, and the only serious part.
Thank you.
favorite question is asked when people, when they see a church organ and a theater organ, what is the difference? It's so obvious, one's in a church and one's in a theater. We've come the time for all of you to do something now in the form of a sing-along, which they did this years ago. It's usually an exercise in futility in our tours that we have here, because some groups are better than others. I get most of the others. But we're gonna put the words on the screen for you. We have a bouncing ball in the form of a modern laser pointer. I better get pretty. You got longer legs than this, don't you? Gosh. And there are a couple of them that have some second verses. And this is the time when you would clamp down the false teeth and take out the chewing gum. Because, and you gotta sing. If you can't sing good, sing loud. I mean, I'll cover you up the best I can. And then, well, I hope you're having fun. Are you so fun? It doesn't matter. We're gonna do this to the end anyway. Sing a long time. Here we go.